Hey folks, and welcome back to the Parkinson's Disease Education Podcast. Today I'm introducing a new series here on the YouTube channel, but for those of you who've been listening in podcast format for a while, on what's formerly known as the Parkinson's Warrior Podcast, you may be familiar with this topic. I did a series earlier in 2023 entitled PD Medications, Purpose, and Mechanisms, and we're going to be doing a retread of that here on the YouTube channel, as well as now on the podcast, the Parkinson's Disease Education Podcast. So for those of you who are here before for the previous versions listening on audio only, this hopefully will be a little bit of a better, cleaner version of what we did before. For those of you who are watching on YouTube who've never heard this material before, it's going to be brand new and I hope even better quality than it was before. So sit tight, fasten your seatbelts, don't change that dial, because in part one, we're going to be talking about COMT inhibitors and all about those that you could possibly want to know. So sit tight and cue music. Welcome to the Parkinson's Disease Education Show, where we demystify the disease and empower you as the person with Parkinson's disease to reach your true potential. The content contained on this show is for informational purposes only and is not meant to be a replacement for information or advice that you receive from your in-person medical or therapy professionals. If you haven't already, I hope you'll consider subscribing. And for an even more personalized experience, please ask us about our memberships. Now, without further ado, let's start the show. Okay, so what are COMT inhibitors? As promised earlier with this series, we're going to be talking about, again, the medication itself, purpose, and the mechanism. So first of all, we need to learn about what COMT even stands for and why it needs to be inhibited. So for those of you who are taking a regular sort of regimen, medication regimen for Parkinson's disease, whether it's levodopa or the combination carbidopa-levodopa, you may or may not know that there are times that you can wear off. So wearing off tends to happen when you're essentially between doses of your Parkinson's medications. So if you're getting towards the time when a new dose needs to be taken of your levodopa, you may actually have a wearing off of the medications where you start to manifest more Parkinson's symptoms, whether it's movement or non-movement symptoms or both. This is a very common problem, and especially for people that have had Parkinson's for a more extended period of time. Wearing off times tend to happen more and more often the longer you've had Parkinson's disease. And it tends to take more and more frequency of doses of levodopa to make those wearing off periods less apparent. That's where COMT inhibitors come in. Now, there are many medications that do what I call bridging the gap and helping to reduce wearing off or off times. And COMT inhibitors are one of those medications. So COMT stands for catechol-O-methyltransferase. And that is an enzyme that breaks up levodopa, particularly in the bloodstream before entering the brain, crossing the blood-brain barrier. So if you don't inhibit COMT, that enzyme, you can have breaking down of dopamine before it even enters the brain. And therefore, you have a lower dose even once it crosses the blood-brain barrier. So the idea behind a COMT inhibitor is it inhibits that enzyme from being activated, and you have in theory, higher levels of dopamine or levodopa in the bloodstream and more available dopamine to be absorbed in the brain. Now, there are four common brands / generics of COMT inhibitors that I'm going to share with you right now. The most common COMT inhibitor on the market is entacapone, or Comtan is the brand name. There's also tolcapone, and then there's Stalevo and opicapone. So your tolcapone is Tazmar. Your Stalevo is the generic carbidopa-levodopa combined with entacapone. And then finally, the opicapone is a brand name of Ongentys. Now, if you've had Parkinson's disease for a while, you may have experienced what's called dyskinesias. Dyskinesias are an abnormal movement or an uncontrolled involuntary movement that you may experience. And dyskinesias are more common at higher or peak doses of dopamine. So as you can imagine, a COMT inhibitor, which will help keep dopamine levels higher in your system, dyskinesia may be an unwanted side effect of the COMT inhibitors. Can't win them all. In addition, though, you may also experience side effects. Most commonly, what I've experienced in patients that I've known that have taken COMT inhibitors is diarrhea. And if the diarrhea is bad enough, you may just need to be off that medication if it's not something that you can deal with. One gentleman that I've worked with had diarrhea so bad that he had to stop the medication altogether and find an alternative medication to help improve the wearing off times. You can also have discoloration of urine. It might be a brown or reddish tinge to it. Confusion and hallucinations, unfortunately, are also a potential side effect. And as you'll find with, I think, several medications in our series, hallucinations tend to be an unwanted side effect of an increase in dopamine. It could also be a problem when you don't have enough dopamine, so it's kind of a double-edged sword. So that's about it about COMT inhibitors. Let's do a quick recap of what we talked about in this video. COMT inhibitors help to bridge the gap between doses of levodopa and helping to reduce so-called wearing off times. COMT stands for catechol-O-methyltransferase, which is an enzyme that breaks down dopamine in the bloodstream. So if you inhibit COMT, theoretically, you're going to help boost the levels of dopamine that are circulating, hence allowing more to be available in the brain. And we talked about the four common brands. Again, I'll rehash those one more time. So we have Comtan or Entacapone, Tazmar or Tolcapone. I have to look at these on a screen or I don't remember the names. Stalevo, which is carbidopa-levodopa, combined with Entacapone, and Opicapone or Ongentys. I'm not going to rehash side effects. Rewind the video for that part, but I will leave a link to a detailed page that you can read some of this information from Parkinson.org or the Parkinson's Foundation here in the United States if you are visual type and you prefer to read this information in addition to hearing it from me. Thanks so much for watching. I hope that this is a good format for you to learn about medications. Of course, ask your doctor about more specific questions in your cases of dealing with the symptoms of Parkinson's disease and or the side effects of your medication. If you have a movement disorder specialist, that's even better because they're going to understand these interactions between medications and side effects even better than a neurologist or a general practitioner. Hopefully these shorter videos are going to be a little bit of an easier pill to swallow.
Pun intended.
Then if we were to do a long presentation on every single medication or on multiple medications in one really long form video. So you let me know in the comments what you think, what your experience has been taking COMT inhibitors. If you're listening to the podcast and other formats, please do leave us a review, especially if we deserve 5 stars. That would be awesome. Well, with that, I'm gonna wrap things up. Thanks so much for watching. Look forward to seeing you in the next video where we discuss another medication, its purpose, and its mechanism. Thanks for watching. Be empowered.